go. Second question coming up. Here it is. Ladies, it's addressed to you. Another $150 waiting here. Marge and Pat have got it all at the moment. Right. Let's see how this one goes. Ladies, it's memory time. What is the very first gift your husband ever gave you? Don't tell us now. What is the very first gift your husband ever gave you? Think about that, ladies, and we'll come back to you in just a moment. It's wonderful to see their faces when, you know, because I can get a pretty good idea how things are going to go by the looks on the faces.
Oh, shut up. Shut up. Is that a busybody?
It's called Tattletales, not Busybody.
Busybody, right.
All right, Pat.
Right. Lose to the clock.
What's the first gift you ever gave her? And we'll see, remember it.
Gosh.
Yeah, that's right.
Oh, gosh.
God, there's been so many over the years.
Yes, of course.
And Patrick and Michael and Tressa. gift.
Gift,
I
yes.
never gave her a gift. I don't some kind of wearing apparel. Yes.
Yes. No, yes is not what I'm after. It's a.
I gave her a yes too, which was a gift.
All right.
It's a gift.
It was a piece of jewelry.
A piece of jewelry.
Yeah.
Okay. You want to go with that? Piece of jewelry.
You stand there and look at me like you don't believe I believe what I just said. You looking at me as if to say I'm lying.
No, that isn't how I was looking at you.
No, it wasn't, was it? But there was something about
you. I was looking at you like, he's going to get this answer right, is how I was looking at you.
Either way. Okay. I think it was a piece of jewelry.
Piece of jewelry. All right, let's bring on Marge. Marge, what was the first gift that Pat ever gave you?
Can I clarify? Is this before we were married or after?
No, it says, it's memory time. It says, what is the very first gift your husband ever gave?
That's 20-some years ago. The first gift he ever gave me before we were married was a I don't know what you call it today. It was a slack outfit, a toreador pant, shocking pink. That's not it.
The boy in blue comes a cropper, folks.
Oh, what did he get me after we were married? Nothing.
Tell her what you said, sir.
I started to say a piece of wearing apparel, and then I changed it to jewelry.
What's
so
jewelry?
I'd like the ring back.
Which ring? The wedding ring?
The other one he gave you before you were married. Yeah.
The one you got in your ear.
You didn't give me an engagement ring.
Huh?
You never gave me an engagement ring.
All right, let's go home in separate cars.
Sorry, dear. No score here. Thank you, though. Army, what's Selma going to say? Do you remember the first gift you ever gave her?
Oh, boy, like Pat, we go back a long time, too. It was when we were both going to school. I was, of course, in college, and she was still in high school, and being as generous as Pat, I gave her a lot of things, too. as long as you
like
accepted a check... Right. No dishes tonight, right? If you accepted a general category like jewelry, I'd have to go with it, because I thought it was either a little locket with a little heart, or it was a little bracelet that had little things on it. So I'll just say jewelry.
Just say jewelry.
Very mundane gifts in any case.
Well, it was mundane and Tuesday.
No, those are very nice gifts. If this is mundane, it must be Hollywood. Selma. Selma, can you remember the first gift that Army ever gave you?
Yes, I can remember it very well. I have an idea that he thinks a different gift was the first gift.
Yes.
And I'll tell you what I think he said, and I'll tell you what the first gift really was.
All right.
The first gift really was a pin, a gold little circle with pearls in it, but he said a starfish pin.
Well, nevertheless, he said jewelry, and we'll accept that, so you're right. Wow. Selma, you're absolutely right. You have the question right. Do you have a memory like that for everything?
I remember everything. I remember who sat in back of me in the second grade.
Oh, my Lord. Army, my congratulations go out to you. My sympathy as well. And you have a share of that.
Yes, she remembers.
Okay. Thank you, darling. Bob, what's Sheila going to say? What's the first game? Here we go, darling.
Yeah, well.
It can't be yes
see,
or no.
You lost, right?
Yes.
You won.
Yes.
Okay, well. I'm going to try now to be succinct about this because there was a lot of stuff and which tended to, as they say, change hands.
They met at a garage sale.
I have a hunch, unfortunately, that she may, in fact, say flowers because the flowers were very particular, very special thing.
Right.
And as a memory. However, the first... Gifts are not, I mean, flowers aren't really a gift. I'm going to try a piece of jewelry which was a small enameled Goldfish.
A small enameled goldfish.
Yeah.
Live?
So it's jewelry. It was to wear.
It was a
small enameled.
It was dead.
Goldfish.
Like a pendant or
it's called belt. A white carp.
All right. A small, or so you want to go with jewelry? Do you want to say a gold?
Say jewelry. Yeah,
all
jewelry.
Right, or do you want to go with a small enameled goldfish?
Well, that she would definitely remember that. Yeah, goldfish.
Goldfish?
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, she can't forget it. I'm telling you, she won't forget it if she goes for that. Maybe the flowers, I don't know.
So you want to say goldfish? Goldfish.
Yeah.
Let's bring on Sheila. All right, Sheila, do you remember the first gift that Bob gave you?
A fish.
That's what he said. See, he knows. He not only knows, he got it right. That's exactly what he said, an enameled goldfish. And that means Army of Selma, Sheila and Bob got it right. They split the pot. Now we're getting close, aren't we? It's halftime, gang. Let us step to the rear. Ladies, come on out here. The blue section is in the lead with $150. And we'll come back to see which section wins it all after this commercial. Please come back with us. Okey-doke, we're back. We've changed places. The ladies are out here with me. The fellas are in the back, ready to go. Everybody has won some money already.
Okey-doke? Whole... Did you say okey-doke?
What's wrong with okey-doke? That's a very that's American very colloquialism.
23 skidoo.
That doesn't come under the same heading of 23 skidoo, does it?
Oh, sure it you does. Bet your sweet patootie.
Well, I don't remember. Okay, fellas, here we go. Second half, here we go.
It's
this is a question
addressed.
Just
the way you say it, Bert.
What is that?
It's just the way you say that, Bert.
Oh, it's the way I say it.
Okie doke.
It's really nice. No, that's
really
good.
They sure like to talk, don't they?
You're picking on me now, gang, but I got a question that's going to straighten you up pretty fast. This question's worth $150 as well to the folks in the audience. The city of Los Angeles has been considering the possibility, if I could read
go ahead.
It.
No, try it again.
Try okey doke.
Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Ed Barbar, right there.
Okey doke, gang. Here comes the next question. The city of Los Angeles has been considering the possibility of allowing nude bathing on some of its beaches. Now, whether or not you wear a bathing suit is optional. That's what they're considering, or were. If you visited such a beach, would you prefer to go in the buff to bathe or in a bathing suit to browse?
Browse.
Now, if you went to such a beach, would you prefer to go in the buff to bathe or in a bathing suit to browse? Think it over. We'll be back in a minute. Okie doke. There they go.
Okey-doke.
All right, Mark.
This is Pat. Now, what he would do.
Yeah, this is what... Well, what do you think?
He has no modesty at all.
No?
If he was visiting a nude beach, he'd go right along with the...
He would,
the
huh?
rest of them.
Oh, sure.
I think.
You really think so, huh?
Yeah, I think so.
Bit of an exhibitionist, is he?
Well, you might say.
Might say that.
It reminds me of this thing on streaking, right?
Yeah.
Go ahead. yeah, I think he would...
Drop his pants for a laugh?
Groove along.
I've heard that about him.
Why not?
Anyway. All right, let's bring him on. Okay, Pat, you're going to the nude beach now. I mean, okie doke, Pat.
I don't know how liberated my wife thinks I am. I think I might go in a bathing suit to shoplift.
Mm. She thought you were more liberated than that, Pat, as a matter of fact.
Apparently she did.
In fact, if you went nude, you'd be totally liberated, wouldn't you? I'm sorry, you didn't share
you
in
lost
that, Pat.
You got your modesty back. I don't know what happened.
It's all right. You still got the lead, but you may lose it on this
we
one.
May.
Selma, what's Army going to say?
This is funny. We did this once.
Did you?
Yes. In Saint-Tropez, where it was, you know, really famous about 4 years ago, we went fully dressed to look at the nude bathers.
Right.
We really dragged ourselves miles for this. We didn't see one person. We saw somebody from L.A. in a pair of shorts that I still see him in at the beach down here. But I would say, knowing Army... that he would positively... What was the choice? How did you express that?
Well, it's either go with us in the buff to bathe or in a bathing suit to browse.
In a bathing suit to browse.
Definitely. Huh?
Definitely.
All right, let's bring him on and find out. Army, what would you do? Would you go in the buff to bathe or in a bathing suit to browse?
I'm what you might call one of the great browsers of your time.
And you would like me to do the same.
You bet.
Okay, Army, you're right. You have a share of the pot. Sheila, what's Bob going to say?
Well, he doesn't have any hang-ups about that, but since he is who he is, we have trouble even having dinner with some privacy. So I guess he'd be a browser.
You think so, huh?
Yeah, I think so.
Okay, let's bring him on. Find out. Bob, what would you do? You're going to wear, you're going to go in the buff to bathe or in a bathing suit to Brown's?
Oh, yeah, it's up to, she's guessing what I'm going to say, uh-huh. Right? Oh, okay. And she would have said that I said I would rather go in a bathing suit.
That's what she said. Yeah. Yeah. Selma and Army and Sheila and Robert share that pot, and we have a tie game, folks. Red, blue, and yellow, all tied. 150 apiece, and we'll come back after this brief word for you. Come back with us now.